Assalamu alaikum. This be with all of you. My topic today is about the greatest person.
Is it Christopher Columbus?
No.
Newton?
No.
A Gandhi?
No.
Maradona?
No. I'm gonna tell you. He is the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Why do you say Muhammad?
You are Muslim and surely you say Muhammad is the greatest person. It's not because of the fact I'm Muslim. Anyone read his biography, he will know that he is the greatest person. Michael Hart, a non-Muslim, read about the biography of Muhammad and chose Muhammad as the greatest person in his book, The 100 Ranking of the Most Influential Persons in History. Look at what Michael said about why he chose Muhammad. My choice of Muhammad to lead the list of the world's most influential people may be surprised some readers and may be questioned by others, but he was the only man in history who was supremely successful in both the religious and secular levels. Tell me, what do you know about Muhammad?
No offense, but what I know is that he was married to a 6-year-old girl.
Is that all what you know? You know that the people who are trying to warp Islam are telling you that it was a flaw. Let me clear that up for you. Was it blemished that Muhammad had married Aisha who was 6 years old?
The Prophet Muhammad married her when she was 6 years old, and he consummated his marriage when she was 9 years old.
I will respond to you from a Christian perspective. Joseph, Virgin Mary's husband, was 90 years old, and Virgin Mary was 12 years old. From the scientific perspective, most girls start their sexual maturity from 8 to 9 years old. Girls who live in hot countries sexual maturity faster than the girls who live in the other places. From the Islamic perspective, Aisha was engaged to someone else before she was engaged to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. That means she was able to marry at that time. If there was a wrong or a blemish, the unbeliever of Quraysh would have criticized Muhammad because the unbeliever of Quraysh hated Muhammad. The most of you don't know truly about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. You just heard about Muhammad from those who tried to worship Islam and Muhammad as evil subjects. Did you hear about his mercy? Look at this example of his mercy. In the day of conquest of Mecca, the day of triumph for the Muslims, the Prophet Muhammad turned to an unbeliever of Quraysh and he said, "Oh Quraysh, what do you think of treatment that I should accord you?" And they say, "Noble brother, a son of noble brother." Thus an unbeliever of Quraysh who killed his friends and tried to kill him and agonize his friends. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, "No reproof against you this day. Go your way, you are free." What's the mercy? Do you know that the biblical prophecy about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him?
I don't think so.
Why not? We believe that the Gospel and Torah were the words of God, but they have been distorted. Look at what Allah said about this. الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل. Allah told us here that the old books prophesied the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Can you show me this prophecy?
Okay, sure. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 18, when God spoke to the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him,
"Will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, like unto thee, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him."
To whom does this prophecy refer?
Jesus.
Jesus? Is Jesus like Moses?
Prophet like Moses.
According to you, Jesus is God, but Moses is not God. According to you, Jesus died for the sins of the world, but Moses did not die for that. According to you, Jesus went to the hell for 3 days, but Moses did not go there. So, Jesus is not like Moses. Now, we will see if Moses was like Muhammad or Jesus.
Moses and Muhammad had a father and mother, but Jesus had only mother.
Moses and Muhammad were born the normal natural course, but Jesus was created by a special miracle.
Moses and Muhammad married and begotten children, but Jesus remained a bachelor all his life.
So, Jesus is not like Moses, but Muhammad like Moses. Look at another prophecy in the book of John, chapter 16, verse 13.
"Albeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will shew you things to come."
The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, did show us the truth. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, disclosed to us what has come. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, did not speak on his own initiative. Another prophecy in the book of John, chapter 1, verse 19 to 22. The Jews were asking about the Christ and Elijah and the Prophet.
"And this is the record of John, when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, 'Who art thou?' And he confessed and denied not, but confessed, 'I am not the Christ.' And they asked him, 'What then? Art thou Elias?' And he saith, 'I am not.' 'Art thou that prophet?' And he answered, 'No.' Then said they unto him, 'Who art thou?'"
They were waiting for the Christ to come. We know that the Christ is Jesus. And they were waiting for Elijah to come. And we know Elijah. And they were waiting for the prophet to come. But who is that prophet? The prophet is Muhammad, peace be upon him. That's what the Bible said about Muhammad.
"I bear witness that there is no God but Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is messenger of Allah. And I bear witness that Jesus is messenger of Allah."
I hope you read more about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you want to know more about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, you can check this website, www.rasulullah.net. Peace be with all of you. Assalamu alaikum. Amen.